Data science is a fascinating field, and luckily, there are tons of excellent reading materials out there to help you master it. I noticed that some of them are not very well known, and I don't see other people recommending them on their channels or elsewhere. I feel that I'm doing you guys a disservice if I don't mention them here on my channel. These books have been absolute game changers for me, not just for learning new concepts, but also for preparing for interviews and solving real-world data science problems. Whether you're just starting out or you're a seasoned data scientist, you will find those books incredibly useful. In this video, I'm excited to share with you some of my all-time favorite books for learning and practicing data science. Since data science is such a vast field, I'm narrowing my recommendations down to two specific areas: statistics and machine learning. So without further ado, let's dive in. First up, let's talk about statistics. If you're new to the field or want to brush up on your knowledge, I've got a recommendation for you. OpenIntro Statistics. It's a great beginner-friendly textbook that covers all the essential concepts that every data scientist should know, including inference and regression. Now, I know this book looks pretty huge, but don't let that intimidate you. It's actually pretty easy to read and understand, especially if you've taking any introductory level statistics courses before. The authors have done a great job of making the content engaging and accessible. Plus, there are plenty of helpful diagrams to help you visualize complex ideas. This book is perfect for beginners who want to get a solid foundation in statistics. And even if you're already working in the field, it's a great resource to have on hand for refreshing your statistics knowledge. The book covers everything from axioms of probability to distributions, hypothesis testing, and regression. So there's something for everyone. The best part? You don't need to sit down and read it all at once. You can pick it up during your downtime and read a few pages at a time. It's not overly technical or difficult to read, so you can easily fit it into your busy schedule. I actually review this book every few months to refresh my memory on statistics. It's that good. And the cherry on top, you can download the ebook for free at www.openintro.org. I have also included the link in the video description. So what are you waiting for? Go check it out. All right, so you've got the fundamentals down, and now it's time to dive a little deeper. The next book I want to recommend is this one, Mathematical Statistics with Recently an R by Laura Chihara and Tim Hesseberg. I've got the first edition, but the latest one is the second edition, and the cover looks a little different. It looks like this. This book is a comprehensive textbook that takes an intermediate level approach to exploring the concepts of mathematical statistics using the Recently method and the R programming language. It covers a range of topics, including probability theory, hypothesis testing, confidence intervals, and linear regression, among others. What sets this book apart from the previous one we talked about is that it's more in-depth and practical. In fact, it's actually a textbook for undergrad stats majors. The authors do an excellent job of explaining reassembly methods like bootstrapping and permutation tests, and they use the reassembly method extensively throughout the book to provide a practical approach to statistical analysis. The book also includes plenty of examples, exercises, and R code to help readers develop a deeper understanding of the concepts. It's an excellent resource for data science professionals who want to expand their statistic knowledge and learn practical skills. Before I read this book, I had heard of reassembly methods, but I didn't fully understand them or know how to use them. But after reading this book, everything clicked into place, and I was able to start using those methods in my own work. By the way, I have to give credit to my friend Yuan for recommending both of these statistics books to me. Yuan is one of the smartest data scientists I know and currently works at DoorDash as a machine learning data scientist. So if they say these books are good, you know they've got to be good. Now let's move on to machine learning. The first book I recommend is The 100-Page Machine Learning Book by Andrew Burkhoff. This book is an excellent starting point for anyone who wants to learn machine learning. It provides a clear and concise summary of the key concepts and ideas, which is really important if you want to understand more advanced topics later on. One of the things I love about this book is that it's only a little over 100 pages long, so you can read it in just one day. And even if you already read other books on machine learning, this one can still be a great refresher, especially if you are preparing for interviews. What I think sets this book apart is how it pieces things together. Instead of looking at all the different machine learning algorithms individually, it talks about the similarities and differences between them, so you can learn how they relate to each other and better understand them. For example, the book does a fantastic job summarizing the three parts of a machine learning algorithm: the loss function, the optimization criterion, and the optimization routine. By understanding these three things, you can organize your knowledge and learn new algorithms more easily. And you can look at all algorithms through the lenses of these three things. As an added bonus, you can actually download some of the book's chapters for free and read them before deciding whether to buy the book. So if you like what you read and find useful in your work or studies, then you can go ahead and buy the book. You can check out the website themlbook.com to learn more. Another great find on machine learning is Machine Learning with PyTorch and Scikit-Learn, which is a comprehensive guide that I use to expand my knowledge in this field. This book is written by experts in the field of machine learning. This book covers everything you need to know about using PyTorch and Scikit-Learn for machine learning. Starting from the basics of machine learning, this book guides you through the installation and setup of PyTorch and Scikit-Learn. One of the things I really appreciated about this book was its emphasis on implementation. The step-by-step implementations of various algorithms, such as principal component analysis and Gaussian mixture model, are particularly helpful in understanding what's happening under the hood. With exercises and coding examples throughout the book, you will have plenty of opportunities to practice and apply what you have learned. But that's not all. The authors provide clear explanations of the concepts and algorithms, and they use real-world examples to show how these tools can be applied in practice. They also take you through some of the more advanced topics in machine learning, including deep learning, convolutional neural networks, and natural language processing. Overall, this book is an amazing resource for anyone who wants to learn how to use these powerful Python libraries for machine learning. As someone who has used this book to expand my knowledge in machine learning, I can say that it is well written, easy to follow, and it covers a wide range of topics. So if you're looking to up your machine learning skills, I highly recommend checking out this book. So once you picked up the machine learning fundamentals, I have a more practical book I'd love to recommend, and that is Designing Machine Learning Systems, an Iterative Process for Production-Ready Applications by Chip Hume. I hope I pronounced that correctly. What makes this book so great is that it's not just for data scientists and machine learning engineers, it's for anyone who wants to become one. The book provides a holistic view of complex machine learning systems, so you will learn not just how to scope a machine learning project, but also how to process data, debug models, and productionize them. And let me tell you, building machine learning models is only a small part of the job. That's why this book does not even cover any machine learning algorithms in detail. By reading this book, you will get a clear understanding of what it really means to be a machine learning practitioner. You will learn how to navigate the day-to-day work involved in processing data, debugging models, and productionizing them. It's really eye-opening, and it will help you make more informed decisions about your career. And if you are already a data science or machine learning practitioner, this book can help expand your knowledge in other areas of the system, such as data engineering, model deployment, and MLOps. One of the key takeaways for me is that what your employers ultimately care about is business metrics much more than fancy machine learning metrics. So it's always important to clearly communicate the business impact of your work in the real world. But that's not all. This book also comes with a GitHub repository that contains practical blog posts on the most up-to-date best practice information available in the industry today. So you can continue learning and staying up-to-date even after you've finished reading the book. So whether you are just starting out in machine learning or you're a seasoned practitioner, I highly recommend checking out Designing Machine Learning Systems. You won't regret it. And don't forget to check out the link in the video description for more information. That's all for today's video on my favorite data science books for learning and practicing statistics and machine learning. I hope you found this information valuable and that it will help you advance your data science skills. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more content like this, be sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell to stay up to date on all my latest content. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and leave a comment letting me know which of these books you're most excited to read. Thanks for tuning in, and I will see you in the next video.